can a truly asymptomatic person transmit this infection to others? How often does that occur? And to what extent is that driving the current epidemic? My name is Isaac Bogoch, and I'm an infectious diseases specialist. Based on a very high-profile study that was recently conducted, the report suggested that the virus was transmitted from someone with no symptoms to other people. A person that traveled from China to Germany for a meeting, this person reportedly felt well, and then on her return trip back to China, it was reported that she subsequently developed some signs and symptoms suggestive of an infection, and indeed this person did test positive for the novel coronavirus. After that, people that were close contacts of the traveler from China who were still in Germany developed some signs and symptoms of infection, and it was found that they too were infected with this coronavirus. After the report came out, it seemed to be discovered that people that were involved with the creation of this report actually never spoke with the individual who came down with the infection directly. After some deeper digging, it turns out that the individual who flew in from China to Germany indeed had symptoms, and it was reported that she had some muscle aches and pains and wasn't feeling that well and was even taking some medications to suppress her fevers. With social media in everybody's palms, you know, there always is the potential for the circulation and, of course, the amplification of misinformation and pseudoscience. So I think it's a good idea to pick a few reputable sources and stick with a few reputable sources. There certainly is a tremendous need for data and, of course, high-quality data. And this data can certainly help medical and scientific teams prepare to treat patients, and it also is helpful for guiding policy, you know, screening programs, treatment programs, prevention programs, vaccination and treatment programs. So the data is extremely important. I think we just need to be mindful that not all data is created the same, and of course there can be some uncertainty with data. If mistakes happen, that's completely okay. We just have to be able to correct them quickly. In general, when we're dealing with respiratory infections, it's usually the case that people who have symptoms, people who are coughing, for example, are just more likely to transmit the infection from one person to another. I also think we have to remember that symptoms can be very broad. Some people can have symptoms and be very, very sick, but we're also hearing about people at the much more mild end of the spectrum with symptoms, that they don't even need to seek medical care because their symptoms are more of a nuisance rather than requiring hospitalization. One of the concerns is it might be challenging to control an epidemic if people are walking around with mild symptoms transmitting the infection, because it's hard to find those individuals, it's hard to identify them and isolate them or prevent them from spreading the infection to others. With emerging data, we'll see what proportion of individuals fall into that category.